Good morning and welcome to Mission Control Houston and the International Space Station update. We're here with the International Space Station Flight Control Team inside the International Space Station Flight Control Room at the Mission Control Center in Houston. Today's flight director is Tomas Gonzalez-Torres, and he's joined today by two Capcoms, actually. Hal Getzelman, at the top center of the screen, is a familiar face at that console, but he's accompanied here by Kate Rubens, who is training for the Capcom position. Here on the ground today, the team, and in particular engineers at the European Space Agency, is looking into what caused a reboost of the space station yesterday to cut off early. The reboost started at 11 a.m. Central Time yesterday and was supposed to last for 31 minutes and 16 seconds. However, the automated transfer vehicle's thrusters, which were being used to boost the station to a higher orbit, cut off after 20 minutes and 37 seconds. That reboost was part of a strategy to use the propellant delivered by the automated transfer vehicle and begin setting the station up for the next Soyuz departure on September 17th, as well as the Progress launch that's going to follow it at the beginning of November. At the moment, it's at an altitude of 255.5 miles by 249.6. Another reboost could be planned for as early as Wednesday to add a couple of miles to that and leave the station in a 257.8 by 251.7 mile orbit. On board the International Space Station, six Expedition 32 crew members are halfway through their day. Commander Gennady Padalka, U.S. Flight Engineers Joe Akaba and Sonny Williams, Japanese Flight Engineer Aki Hoshide, and Russian Flight Engineers Yuri Malenchenko and Sergey Revin got their wake-up call at 1 a.m. Central Time this morning to start a full day of science and maintenance activities, as well as spacewalk preparations. The crew has been together now for about a full month. Williams, Hoshide, and Malenchenko arrived aboard their Soyuz 31S on July 16th, and they've been in space now for 33 days and at the space station for 31. They're planning to stay until November. Akaba, Padalka, and Revin, on the other hand, launched on May 14th and have been in space for 94 days now at the station for 92. They'll be heading back to Earth in their own Soyuz vehicle next month. Flying at an altitude of about 260 miles above the Pacific Ocean, just about to reach the southernmost portion of this orbit around the Earth and begin heading northeast across South America. The first item on today's agenda for the entire crew was a safety briefing to prepare for the upcoming Russian spacewalk scheduled for Monday. The entire crew got together to talk through what those inside should be prepared for in the unlikely event of an emergency. And then the spacewalkers, Gennady Padalka and Yuri Malenchenko, went to work getting their spacesuits moved into place and gathering their equipment and tools. Meanwhile, here on the ground, the flight controllers are moving the space station's robotic arm, Canadarm 2, from the Harmony node across the Destiny laboratory and then into the arm's mobile base to get it into position to provide good camera views of the spacewalk, which is scheduled to begin at 9:40 a.m. on Monday, with NASA TV coverage picking up at 9 a.m. Central Time. The rest of the station's crew spent at least part of their day working on a variety of science experiments. Flight engineer Joe Akaba performed a run of the BAS experiment, that stands for Burning and Suppression of Solids, and test the hypothesis that all other things being equal, materials in microgravity burn as well or better than they would in gravity. Flight engineer Sonny Williams replaced a camera on the InSpace 3 experiment, which studies the fundamental behavior of magnetic colloidal fluids under the influence of various magnetic fields in hopes of improving our ability to design structures such as bridges and bridges to better withstand earthquakes. Flight engineer Aki Hoshide, meanwhile, prepared for another segment of the integrated cardiovascular experiment that looks at how being in space affects astronauts' heart muscles. And he also replaced a disk drive on the combustion integrated rack's fluid and combustion facility. And on the Russian side of the station, flight engineer Sergey Revin worked on the identification and bar experiments. Identification is aimed at identifying sources of vibrations that disrupt the microgravity conditions on the space station. Those conditions are important for many of the experiments that go on board the space station. And the bar experiment looks at different methods of detecting leaks on the station. That's what's going on in space today, and this is Mission Control Houston.